Today, I want to talk about a pedal that, in my opinion, has been unnecessarily devalued. This is the DOD Boneshaker. Now, when it came out about 4 years ago, it was marketed as a high-gain distortion unit intended to be used with extended-range guitars, low-tuned instruments that you might find in progressive and heavy metal music. And although it does that stuff well, I ended up getting this pedal on a great deal, and I enjoy the lower gain use of it too. And I'll explain all that. I'll give some presets further on in the video. But right now, I just want to share my thoughts on why it's so cheap in the market. So back up a year and a half ago when I got the pedal, Harman Audio decided that it was going to close its DOD pedal line. And although they had just come up with a bunch of really cool circuits in the recent years, they decided to shut it down completely. So DOD was forced to get rid of its entire stock of pedals. I ended up getting this for $30 shipped to my door. $30 free shipping. And I think that alone is responsible for the really low prices online. If you go on Reverb right now, you can find them floating around for $45-$50. I'll show you a screenshot right now of the price guide and how that's gone down a bit since they were offered for $30. That whole thing is the reason you can find these so cheap. So for someone that paid full price for this, this kind of sucks. I believe it was originally sold for $150. It had an MSRP of $180-something. They ended up settling on $150, and I mean, plenty of people bought it for $150, but it ended up not selling so well, I guess. The circuit was designed in part by Black Arts Toneworks and mass-produced by DOD. It's a really solid gain pedal. So if you want to talk about the controls on this pedal, we just have a regular distortion knob that for like the first 70% of the pedal really doesn't add much. And then once you get about here, it really starts adding in a ton of gain all at once. We've got a depth knob, which is supposed to be something that sorts out the low frequencies and helps an extended range instrument really cut through the mix. I don't have one of those instruments, and I've tried it on my guitar, which is just a normal standard tune 6-string. I haven't found much use of it for myself. And then we have a normal level control. And the really cool thing about this pedal, and which might be a reason that you want to jump on this and try it out for such a cheap price, we have a 3-band EQ at the bottom. And not only is it a 3-band EQ, but you're actually controlling the notch where the frequency is set at for each of those 3 bands. So you're controlling the notch and the level of each. You can see that these 3 knobs are double layered. So the top knob is gonna control the level of that frequency notch, and then the bottom knob is gonna control where that frequency lies. So I think for that reason alone, this is a really pretty cool pedal to have and keep in your collection just for that one instance that you might want to go for a unique distorted sound. Something that comes to mind is like ZZ Top Lagrange. It has like this kind of notched overdrive sound where you can pick out a certain set of frequencies that are really being pushed by the overdrive, and that gets this idea. It might also give you an effect where if you like playing with a wah pedal where you're not touching the wah, you turn it on, you find a nice spot to leave it at, and then you got like this crazy mid-range direction to your sound. It can do that in one click. So you might want to get this on your board just to save for, you know, just a one-off odd sound that you're using. Or maybe you really like adding in a ton of high end to the sound to help it cut through the mix. Or maybe you want to roll off the highs and the mids and just have a really low bassy tone to kind of fill up the sound in a band. There's a lot of different uses for this pedal, and I'm going to show you a couple presets that you can find if you decide to get this. I'm playing my PRS McCarty. This is just a very low gain Les Paul style guitar, solid body. And then I'm gonna be playing it through the Supro Tremoverb behind me. I'll give you my clean sound first so you can see where I'm coming from. And all the overdrive you're gonna be hearing is coming from the DOD Boneshaker. I have it mic'd up with an MXL V250, like this guy right here, going into an interface then. I hope you guys enjoyed this video or found it useful in some way. This has been the DOD Boneshaker that I've really been pleased with. I had it for a year and a half, and I think when I got it, I was still under the influence of the demos I had seen and what this pedal was intended to be used for. But in fact, I found a lot more use out of it for myself. Keeping it on the lower gain settings, you can get some really interesting, great sounds out of it. So anyway, you can pick it up on Reverb for like 45, 50 bucks used. I definitely recommend having something like this in your collection. So hope you enjoyed the video. I'll see you next time.